joining us, we have Coach Jim Fox. He is the new head coach of Appalachian State University's men's basketball team. Thank you so much for being with us today.
Oh, it's great to be here on your last day, both your guys' last day. I feel like I'm special. I feel like it's the end of an era right here.
Yeah, that's
it. It's a pretty special show today, but we're excited to have you. Go ahead and start by kind of introducing yourself to our viewers and telling us a little bit about how you ended up here in Boone.
Yeah, you know, I was a high school coach in New York right after college. And did a couple of years there, and then Coach McKillop down at Davidson came and got me and said, do you want to come break into the college ranks? Come, hired me as a volunteer assistant, so I was making no money. And so I drove down. I'd never been in Davidson before, and you know, I think the only time I'd been in North Carolina was Charlotte Airport, you know, just connecting. And so I went down there, loved it, and after 2 weeks, I did such a great job. He promoted me, so I was making money after 2 weeks, which was good. Not much, but I was making it.
Yeah, money's
and
a good
then,
thing.
Yeah, and then... Yeah, I'd been there for 13 years, and so now, you know, wanted to be a head coach, and this wonderful opportunity presented itself.
Perfect.
Yeah.
Now, what can you tell us about the transition from coming from Davidson to now being a Mountaineer?
Well, first of all, I just finally moved into my place yesterday. That was the toughest thing, and we lost the moving truck for a couple hours too, so that was not fun.
Oh, no.
But I'm finally, the courtyard where I stayed was great, but I was glad to get out of there, glad to get into my own place. But the transition has been exciting. It's been, you know, I've been running around trying to get as many people into the program, involved with the program as I possibly could, whether it be here in Boone, whether it be in Charlotte, Raleigh, Greensboro, Hickory, anywhere they want to send me, I've been going just to try and build excitement for the program. The guys, you know, we worked out with the players for about 3 weeks. They went home and they get back in July. So it's been a lot of recruiting and non-basketball things trying to get the community excited about our program.
Right. So you talked a little bit about saying that you were doing high school basketball.
Mm-hmm.
So how different is it going from high school to college?
Well, I tell you what, I mean, you know, that's one thing people don't understand is that there's a lot of really good coaches mm-hmm. at the high school level who just don't want to be college coaches. They love teaching in a classroom and they love the high school basketball. So, you know, everything's different about it. I mean, you know, from recruiting, from, you know, when you first come and you become a college basketball coach, you think that, you know, I'm just going to be doing basketball. Mm-hmm. It's not even close. There are so many other things as a college coach you have to do to do your job well. And that's the one thing, you know, people come from high school to college, they don't realize that, and it hits them pretty quickly.
Say.
Yeah.
Now, is being a head coach something that you have always aspired to do?
Yeah. You know, I want to, you know, like anybody who's a competitor, you want to get to that highest level, and I think being a Division I head coach is only 300-something jobs. And, you know, when you achieve that, you know, you feel pretty good, but then you feel pretty good for about a minute, and then you have to, you know, now you want to make sure you do a good job, make sure everything you've worked for, you've planned for, you've prepped for, and now, you know, once you're there, now you got to do a really good job.
Absolutely.
Definitely. So looking ahead to this upcoming season, talk with us a little bit about what you're planning and expecting. Any goals?
Yeah, we want to, you know, I told our guys we just want to get better every day, and that's our goal. I mean, if we get better every day, you know, everything else will take care of itself. You know, we're putting together a very challenging schedule. I think a schedule that will prepare our guys for when we get into Sun Belt play. You know, in February and March, we're playing our best basketball. So I think, you know, you want to say, oh, I want to win a championship. Oh, we want to do this, we want to do that. But we just try and simplify it and just say, just get better every day, have fun doing it. And we do those things, and we're going to be okay.
So our practices have started?
You know, they haven't. We had workouts, and then the guys have been gone home, mm-hmm. and then they'll come back in July. And then we can practice for 2 hours a week. The NCAA allows us to practice with our guys. So we'll have them on campus and practice and give them a little taste of what they're going to expect come in the fall.
Absolutely. And then once school starts, talk with us a little bit about the practice schedule and how demanding it is for these players.
Well, it's demanding. You know, You know, they have to really learn to balance their lives. And, mm-hmm. and you know, they have to make sure they're taking care of their academics. They have to make sure, because there's so much time involvement
right.
with their academics and then also with us. You know, they'll come in right away. They're lifting, they're conditioning, they're working out, and they're playing. And in that fall season, and it's almost better. I think it's easier for the guys once the season starts and we practice, you know, 2.5 hours every day. They know when the practice is, and that's what they got to do. Otherwise, they're spread out all over the day. We keep them occupied.
Yeah,
sounds like it. Now, moving conferences as well, talk with us about how that's going to play into this next season.
You know, I think it works out perfectly for me because I'm new. Right. And so everything's going to be new about this year. You know, we're staying in new hotels. We're playing different teams we don't know. We're traveling to places a lot of us don't know. So, you know, everything's new. So I guess if I could describe the season in one word, it'll be that. And, you know, but it's exciting, though. It gets your blood flowing. It's a new challenge, and it will definitely be a challenge trying to figure out, you know, how we're going to get from Texas State to Texas Arlington and, you know, back home in time to play Arkansas Little Rock. So, but I think it gives us, like Chancellor Peacock said, it gives that App State footprint in different areas of the country now. And I think that's great for the university.
Absolutely.
And a lot more travel involved this year.
There will be a lot more travel, but you know what? We have people, our support staff, you know, our academic people who are going to be with us, you know, they're ready for it and make sure we don't, you know, when we unfortunately have to miss a class, you know, our guys will get that work done and be able to have people help them with the stuff they miss. So
that's great. So is there anybody we need to be watching out for this year?
You know what? Your guess is as good as mine. You know, it's I think I've been so happy with the way the guys have worked, the way the guys have continued to work when they're home. Obviously, we're in constant communication with them. You know, and I'm expecting big things from all of them. You know, we did say it's a clean slate. You know, so whether they played 2 minutes last year a game or they played 35, everything's new this year. And they have a chance to really make their mark on this program and build this program going forward.
Yes.
But can you kind of talk with us about the team as far as how many seniors, juniors, and then who's coming in new this year?
Yeah, we're trying to get Tommy Spagnola his 6th year. That's mm-hmm. a process you go through, and our administration, Jonathan Reeder, has been working extremely hard with that, trying to get him. Hopefully we find out soon whether or not Tommy can come back. And, you know, and then we have a large junior class, mm-hmm. And so then you go on, and our three freshmen, we have three freshmen signed. For this year, they've been admitted, and you know they come from one's from Serbia, one's from Ohio, and the other one's from Toronto. So yeah, App State's reaching into places, mm-hmm. you know, all different kind of places around the world. So it's exciting.
Definitely.
Great. Now, one thing that you've really stressed so far is getting the community involved. Talk with us about that.
Yeah, you know, I called it at my press conference the App Army. You know, we need people, and it's just not saying, okay, I'm going to go to a game. That's not good enough. We need you to go grab 4 or 5 people and bring them to a game. We need to get the businesses in the city of Boone involved. We need to get people to drive up the mountain to come see games. But we want, you know, it's our responsibility to build that enthusiasm, to build that excitement. And I think, you know, we're off to a good start. We got to keep momentum. I joked that I wanted to be mayor of Boone before our first game.
Yeah.
So I think we're trying as our staff to do that, and just to really get people interested, to get people excited, and give fans ownership. I said, you know, if you're around and we're practicing, come to a practice, come watch us practice, come see how hard the guys work. You know they work hard on game days, you see that, but you don't see what goes into preparing for game days. So we just want to give people, especially the people of this community, ownership of this program. This is their program. This is the school's program. This is the alums program, season ticket holders program, and we want them to feel a part of it.
Absolutely.
Awesome. Is there anything that has surprised you so far being the head coach at Appalachian?
How long do we have here? No, I'm just kidding. the people, you know, when I came up as an assistant at Davidson, people weren't very nice to me up here. And then, but it's amazing how nice the people in this community are and how welcoming they've been, how they're willing to help. You know, anything you need, let me know. Anything you need, let me know. That's all I hear from people. And they're genuine about it. So that's, you know, that makes you feel good. You know, it makes you feel like, hey, this is going to be a great spot to not only to coach, but to live. And that's really been, I don't know if it's surprising, but it's been very welcome.
Great.
Wonderful.
So.
I'm sure that is an interesting dynamic when you competed against Appalachian before. And
sure.
Now you're here.
Yeah, you know, you walk into homes and there's a big picture of a packed home center, and I'm sitting on the other bench, you know, for Davidson. So it's, you know, but it's, as I said, you know, there's great fans up here, fans that want to win, fans that want to program it, those things the right way. And, you know, that's our plan, is to give that to them.
Absolutely. Awesome. Well, it sounds like it's going to be a great season for the men's basketball team. And thank you so much for coming in to talk with us today.
No, it was great being here. And as I said, good luck to both of you guys, too. We're all it's something new for all of us, right?
New chapters.
Thank you.
Well, thank you so much. And we will be back right after these messages with more of the Mountain Television Network.